Artist trading coins continue to be enormously popular, with all of the credit going to Joanne Hodges, the creative force behind the entire idea of morphing an artist trading card's rectangular shape to a circle. In today's video, I'll introduce you to our new artist trading coin label stamp that allows you to easily record the pertinent information about a coin on the reverse. I'll also show you some quick ways to use our 6 new coin collage sheets that debuted a short time ago, and I'll do that on our Watercolor Art Parts blank coins. Since the label stamp is new today, that's where I'm going to begin. It's sized to easily fit on the standard 2.5-inch artist trading coin, and it includes spaces for you to record all of the important information: the date the coin was made, the name, the artist's name, and the edition. You can stamp directly on the back the way that I did here, or you can stamp on a piece of paper and adhere it. It's entirely up to you. I've stamped on the back with the comfort of knowing that if I screw it up, I can always stamp on paper and fix it that way. So I'm working with, let's get these out of the way. I'm working with our 3x4 acrylic mount, mainly because I can't find my 3x3 one. And if I hold this up, you'll notice that I've drawn a horizontal line on here. Sorry, the glare. I've drawn a horizontal line on here that is perpendicular to the top and the bottom of this. And you'll notice that there are berries at 12 and 6. Now, Joanne suggested to me putting the berries at 12 and 6 as an aid to alignment. And then I realized that if I did that, and I aligned the lines on the stamp with the line on the mount, it was pretty hard to screw it up. It gives you a nice reference point to know that your stamped image is going to be aligned properly and square to the front, the image on the front of your coin. So coming back to these for a second, these are an example of one of the new collage sheets that were new a week ago. These are ones that feature some flowers on here. They're meant to be adhered directly to your coin blank, which is what these are. These are our 2.5-inch coin blanks, and I've used some of Tim's small talk stickers and a little bit of stickles to enhance them, because really you can't hate it. When it is time to stamp, I like to work on a piece of paper towel folded in half. I find that that cushion helps me to get a really good impression. So here is another one of the collage sheets that was new a week ago. Now obviously it's important that when you stamp this, you want to be certain that you are aligned vertically with the image on the front of the stamp. So what I generally do is I will grab this, and let me look at this for 1 second. So this, the bird is kind of on an angle. I would grab this at 12 and 6, I would flip it, and then I would place it face down on the piece of paper towel. When you look at the stamp, don't do what I did, which is, if you look at this particular coin, you can see that it is oriented correctly, but if you look at the reverse, you can see that it's upside down. This stamp, obviously, is directional. Across the top are the words "artist trading coin," on the bottom are "handmade art." If you remember that the part with 3 words has to be at the top, you won't make that same mistake that I did. So I'm using stays-on. And with this particular group, because I've used a collage sheet image on the front, there's nothing sprayed, so the backs are nice and clean. Having said that, when I look at something, well, I don't have one that the back is visible, but looking at something like this where I've sprayed, I know the back of this is a mess, so I just put paper on there to cover it up. So anyway, this is why I don't have anything on here already. Now you can choose to color the back if you want. All right, so let's pay attention. 3 words. This goes like this. I know that this is basically the 12 o'clock position. I'm going to pull this toward me so I can look straight down. So I'm going to align the berries at 12 and 6. I'm going to eyeball centering the stamp on the back of that artist trading coin, and then I'm just going to press. And as I said, I like having the paper towel underneath. The cushion allows me to get a good impression. So I'm just going to give this a really good press. You don't want to twist. You don't want to rock if you can avoid it. And there you go. When I do this, I use a Sharpie. This is permanent. This is permanent. I don't ever have to worry about this getting damp and anything changing. Now the interesting thing, though this is sized for a 2.5-inch coin, we have coin blanks in 3 inches in diameter too, and you can see that it works perfectly well on the back of one of the larger ones. These six collage sheets debuted a week ago. Each features three coordinating designs that are sized at just over 2.5 inches, allowing you to center the blank coin on the back and trim it once the glue dries. So you can see, you've seen imagery from these before. This is, I'm going to work with in a minute for something else. These adorable little pumpkins, the flowers that you saw previously, these fun mushroom things, and I'm going to work with this one right now, these sweet little birds. So when I do this, again, these are sized at just a tick over 2.5 inches, which means all I need to do, let's get that out of the way, and I'll work with this one first. All I do is I rough cut this around the edge, and it doesn't have to be perfect, but by cutting it around the edge like this, I have a coin that's a little bit larger than 2.5 to center a 2.5 inch coin on, and of course I can't cut and talk at the same time. Good grief. Anyway, having this slightly larger than 2.5 inch circle means I have something to center the coin on. So I'm going to use Scotch Quick Dry Tacky Adhesive because it does exactly what the name implies. The glue sets really quickly. Just put some on there. Now I'm going to kind of stand up and look down because I want to center. You have a little bit of time to move this, but I'm going to roughly center this coin blank on the back of that piece from the collage sheet, and then I'm just going to grab a piece of paper, paper towel rather, and smooth this out, and I'm going to catch any adhesive if I happen to be a little bit too generous and it leaks out. Ordinarily, I don't trim these until the glue is dry, but for the sake of argument, I will show you that it's pretty simple to do. You're just going to run your scissors up the edge or along the edge of that circle and let it guide the scissors as you go around the perimeter. Sometimes I'll come back if I have a spot that's not particularly smooth. I'll come back and trim it, but you can see how easy it is, and you can see how adorable those silly little birds are. They just are really cute. So here's the other nice thing to think about. When you look at the imagery, and both of these are a really good example, if you decide that you want the imagery without the background, that's easy enough to do too. So here, let me bring the other ones in. I had some blanks that I did a while ago that, this one is glued up, that I had done and I had put in a drawer because I wasn't certain what I was going to do with them. A lot of times I'll make a bunch at once, and then when I'm ready to play, if I don't want to mess around with backgrounds, I don't have to. So I have taken the imagery from this sheet and cut it out individually and placed it on this coin. So again, this one is dry. You can see that it's ready to go. Now, will I put some other things on here? I probably will. Off the top of my head, I don't really know what yet. But the thing that puts these or pulled these all together and makes them very obviously part of a series is the fact that the backgrounds are all the same. They feature the birds for the ravens from that same collage sheet, and I've used little bits of dictionary paper to add some other elements on there. I could add Chit Chat stickers, I could add Big Chat stickers. There's lots of different ways to further embellish these. But you can see that the imagery on these collage sheets is scaled to fit perfectly on these 2.5 inch diameter artist trading coins. So artist trading coins are a lot of fun to create, and once again, congratulations and an enormous thank you to Joanne for dreaming them up.